Hello friends, my name is Deval Shah and welcome to KU Knowledge Center. In last video, we learned about how RSI works, relative strength index works. But in this video, we're going to be learning how to make a strategy and backtest it. Okay, so if you haven't seen the last video, please find the link in the description box. And now let's move on to strategy without wasting any of the time. So I will log in into the KU. Now let me first explain you the strategy actually, and then we actually execute it. Okay? So I will take grammar. I'll take this 10 minutes of time frame so I can make you understand better. And 10 minutes of time frame is actually good for this strategy. Put RSI. Now the first strategy itself will put runway. This would be 60. This would be 40. So you see, what we'll do is a simple thing over here. What we know about RSI is people keep buying and RSI keep on increasing. It go on to the overbought area. And similarly, when RSI is decreasing, basically it's getting a bearish trend, people are selling in the market and it's going to oversold area. So we'll take an advantage of this. What we'll do is when the RSI crosses above 60, we'll buy it. See, we'll buy it over here approximately. And accordingly, we'll take a profit, something over. On the reverse side, when RSI crosses below 40, we'll sell it and take a profit. Okay, a very simple strategy. You'd have heard on many of the YouTubers or many of the analysts would be telling about this kind of strategy. But what I would suggest is follow them because they are smart people. But do your own analysis. Do make the strategy on KU, backtest it, optimize it, and know that this strategy works for this particular stock or doesn't work for a stock. You'll come to know. Okay, so let's move on and make the strategy out of it. So this is our RSI strategy. Let's say 60-40 strategy. Okay, what we'll do is we'll take a both side, like we'll buy and sell both on. We'll take a 10 minutes interval. We'll have a candlestick. So RSI crosses above 60. One more addition I'll make over here. What we'll do is we'll have whenever it's a green candle only, we'll buy it. Okay. So how do I do that? Previous close should be lower than current close. This would be cross below. Now this has to be the red candle, right? Previous close has to be higher than. I can keep open also. That's your personal choice how you want to make your strategy. So it's a KU is very flexible in telling you how you should be making your strategy. What I'll do is I'll keep two percent stop loss and 2.5 is my take profit with trailing stop loss on. So trailing stop loss will tell me where if I'm start gaining that the stop loss will keep on going on upward direction. Now we'll run the strategy on HDFC Bank. HDFC. These are few of the stocks which are one of my favorites and keep on working on the strategy. Right. Access and Asian Paint, good looks. I'll buy 20 stocks. This is a number intraday. Let's take last 3 months. And 55 branch. Same that. Okay, so we have your end result. In HDFC, we got 14% return, like something in 3 months, we earned some amount, PNL, Asian Paint we got. So this is how we created. Let's add one more to make you understand how it would be like. You can see all green ones. Obviously, this particular strategy are working for this particular stock. But if I add, let's say, ICICI Bank. I hope I get profit, but so you see, this particular strategy doesn't work for ICICI Bank in this particular phase, this particular time phase. You need to know which stock and which time frame or which basically phase of a stock you should be working with this particular strategy. Okay, so now let me explain you more how HDFC has been performing. So we got this particular return, 5% return over here. But good part is, I'm not losing a lot of money on the brokerage also. My wins are good, losses are also there. Drawdown is a little cash. Total orders are good, wins are good. So if you see, I get a daily return of how it's actually performing. On daily basis, how I'm earning. So we are earning good actually on most of the days. We are earning 500, 700 bucks per day. And on drawdown side, on a basically loss side, we are actually losing something 400. We can cut short on the losses using optimization. Let's say buy and sell graph. Good, that's good. We are buying on the good days. Yeah, we are buying on good days, selling on the good days. Pretty good strategy. So you get a position value, how it's been performing when we are into market. Like when you already have a position, how it's been performing over here. You get transactions, all the time. Yeah, this is pretty good strategy we have made. So now let's move on to the second strategy. If you have any doubts on this particular strategy, please leave your comments and we'll try to solve it out for you. Now the second strategy is, you would have heard by many of the analysts or many of the YouTubers telling you this particular strategy. We'll put on 10 minutes only. This would be RSI. Yes, the strategy which came out 70 and 30. We'll sell it when it's 70, crossing below 70, right? And we'll buy it when it's crossing above 30. Now, in this particular phase, it looks very amazing to buy it over here and selling over here. We would have got a very amazing profit. Let's say approximately 100 rupees per share. But now this particular strategy, you'll be working on the, let's say 3 months, 4 months, and how to earn the money. That's what we'll do on the key. We'll make a strategy, RSI 70, 30, questions. We can go both 10 minutes. Yeah. Analyst RSI crossing. We'll buy when it crosses above 30. Similarly on RSI crossing below 70. I'll keep a 1.5 stop loss and 2 as a take profit with trailing stop. You see, my risk to reward ratio is a little different over here because I'm using trailing stop loss. So it gives me an advantage over here. I'll keep Piramal Finance, good company, pharma, same quantity, but the same face, bullish right now. I might just need 30,000. Okay, so we got some 17% return over here with Muthoot Finance. Let's analyze it more. What's the win to ratio? The wins are good, 23 wins, loss are bit 15. But we are kind of earning big when we are going, when we are earning actually. So kind of in range of 500 per day we are earning. Which is top, we have a loss also in some cases. Quick buy and sell graph. If we are selling at the peak, we are buying at the bottom. Buying at the bottom, we are selling at the peak. That's good actually. Yep, the strategy is good actually. And position value, if you see, yeah. So we are right on almost at a peak of drawdown. See that? Okay. So graph looks very good. Position value graph looks very good. Really. They are kind of scaling upwards. And that's why SQN is also very positive. SQN tells that. How's the return? Is a consistent return we are getting after the strategy? Because that's more important for anyone. We don't want any kind of strategy who earns in only once in one particular phase. It's kind of one time luck. No, we need someone with a consistent profit should be paying. That's why what SQL tells about. Gives a consistent, stable, higher returns. Values are over here. At the transactions, we will get it over here. This is pretty much the two strategies which we could make with the RSI. There are many more strategies you can try on the key platform. It's open for all. You can use it. You can make your own strategy. In upcoming videos, we will be going more towards the indicators, explaining the indicators and the strategies related to that. In that particular strategies also, we'll be using RSI because RSI gives a lot of confirmations that this is a phase you should be buying or selling, right? If you have any doubts, any queries, please put it on the comment section. And don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.